Good evening, everyone. I'm Carmine Jimé. As kids, we tried all different types of sports. Some we were decent at and still play today. But you'll never know unless you try. Well, the Casper Ice Arena is offering kids their first pair of skates. The Mile High Mites program is a partnership with the Colorado Avalanche. Its goal is to introduce 4 to 8-year-olds to hockey. For $190, kids get 6 one-hour training sessions. That's every Saturday morning from September 21st to October 26th. You gotta love that reaction. The program also provides them with all the gear they need to play. Plus, the players and parents get one session on the ice at the Pepsi Center, home of the Avalanche. Here's Chad Green on the importance of the Mile High Mites.
This is a zero barrier entry into hockey. It's a great experience for the kids to lace up the skates, buckle the helmets, and jump on the ice for the first time, or maybe that's their second time on the ice. Either way, we want them out here playing hockey.
From skates to boots, the 7th performance at the National High School Finals Rodeo is going on right now in Rock Springs. So let's check out our current event leaders. We have 3 boys tied for the lead in saddle bronc riding. We had 2 big 80-plus point rides last night and this morning. That's Cooper Cook in bareback riding and Justin Woodward in bull riding. Gillette Sheho is 5th in the nation in pole bending. Also 5th in the country is Yoder native Hayden Thompson in goat tying with a time of 7.44 seconds. Our best Wyoming cowboy or cowgirl right now is in reined cowhorse. Warland native Maddie Fantasky is currently 2nd with 294.5 points. And just behind her is the Big Piney team ropers Ari Espensheed and Colby Bradley. They're currently 3rd in the country with a time of 7.09 seconds. Now, the Wyoming girls were 1st in the country as of last night. Right now, they're 380 points back in 2nd. The Wyoming boys are 12th as a team. And overall, Team Wyoming is 4th among the 43 states and provinces in the big dance. Yesterday, I told you the Cheyenne Post 6th Legion baseball team will not be participating in the AA state tournament. Instead, they'll attend the Connie Mack World Series in Farmington, New Mexico. Well, the Cody Cubs have decided to fill that spot in the AA state tournament. And that's a big deal for Cody because they're last year's single-A champs. Now they'll be playing up into AA. Cody manager Bart Grentz accepted the offer from Legion baseball chairman Cody Beers last night. The Cubs now go from the 1st seed in the Single-A West Conference to the 4th seed in the Double-A East Conference. So now both Single-A and Double-A tournaments will be 8-team double elimination. Down in Denver, the Broncos reported to training camp today. They have the first of 19 practices open to the public tomorrow. The Broncos start the preseason with the Hall of Fame game from Canton, Ohio. That'll be Thursday, August 1st against the Atlanta Falcons. Then the Broncos open the regular season on Monday Night Football, September 9th, at the Oakland Raiders. By that time, new quarterback Joe Flacco will likely be the Week 1 starter. But for now, he's trying to earn the respect of his new guys.
When I went to the New York Jets, I made it a mission. I had a mission to go out and prove to these guys that I could still play the game and play at a high level. And I think that Joe Flacco will come in with the same type of attitude that he needs to prove something. He needs to prove to his teammates that they can rely on him, that he's going to come to practice prepared. He knows all the plays. The leadership, I don't think that'll be a problem at all. He has that down pat.
And guys, today the San Francisco Giants completed a 4-game sweep of the Rockies. Bad news, but the Open Championship of Golf starts tomorrow.
Well, I guess people can already look forward to the Broncos.
Yep, that's right.
The Rockies have to.
We got the next season. We're already done.
Baseball. There you go. Baseball.
We'll be right back.